Hi, Jason Brewers. Welcome to my new series on the French defense. I've been working on building my opening repertoire with together with the IM Kostaya Kajurski on my Patreon page, and I thought, why not also try to learn even more by doing a YouTube series on the French defense and really and also share some of the new knowledge I've gained with you. And I hope you will find this interesting. If you want to follow the series, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and so you will get a message when I post new episodes in the series. And first off, I want to start on the classical variation in French, which I play myself. I want to just give a short introduction to the different variations I will cover in this section or series. The opening the French defense start with the e4 e6 and then d4 d5 knight c3, and now you have the classical variation with the knight f6, but here, but black also has the option going for the winnable variation with the bishop to b4, or taking on e4, and after knight takes e4, knight d7, you have the so-called Rubenstein variation. You can also here play bishop to d7, and after knight f3, play the bishop to this nice diagonal, which is why the reason by this double move of the bishop here is to develop the light squared bishop, which is often a problem piece in the French opening. And this variation is called the Fort Knox variation. But all these are not part of the classical variation with knight f6. And here the main line is e5, called the Steinitz variation. And here black plays the knight back to d7, and here it helps the push of the c pawn to c5. But e5 is not the only move for white. He can also play this move called bishop to g5, which is called the burn variation, creating a pin on the knight. So you suddenly have to watch out for this e5 move, since your knight is pinned to the queen. So that's one option. White can also take here on d5, which suddenly leads to the exchange variation. So it's called the delayed exchange variation. And there's also the move bishop to d3, which is called the Swiss variation. It's not played that often, but I want to cover it anyways. So this are the moves, the main moves in white has to choose from. In part one of the series, I want to look at e5, the Steinitz variation. In second part, I want to look at the burn variation, and then I won't go into the delayed exchange variation because it's the transposition into the exchange variation, and so therefore I want to in part three look at the Swiss variation before going on to other episodes in covering the French opening. So I hope you want to follow, and please click on the part one that will show here when I've uploaded later. And enjoy. Bye.